Hello dear students, assalamu alaikum. I am your maths teacher. So today we'll be studying from new syllabus mathematics D1 7th edition. So already we have started with the first lesson, and this is my second lesson from this book. So we will start from page number 6, and this is a practice question. That here it is given that 537 and 59 are prime numbers or composite numbers. Okay? So you have to tell whether 59 is prime or composite, 537 is prime or composite. So how do you find this? So simply you check by dividing the number with 2, 3, 5, 7 or 9. So if it is divisible and makes factors, so then it is composite numbers. And if it doesn't make factors and it is divisible by itself only, then it is prime number. So 537 has factors 13, 139, 530, so it is composite number. And 59, it doesn't have any factors, so it is prime number, right? So second question is, it is a puzzle like, in this game, a policeman chasing a thief. The policeman can only step on tiles with prime numbers. Right here, different numbers are given, and it's a game like the policeman is chasing someone, a thief. So the policeman has to step on the prime numbers only. So the policeman can only step on tiles with prime numbers. Shade the tiles to trace route that he can take. So he said that you can color or shade the tiles which are on the prime numbers. So here I have shaded with the color 11, 5, 89, 61, 53, 37. These are all prime numbers. So if you find any, you can color that also if I have missed, right? Okay. Now we move to another page. So this is an example given, right? So if P and Q are whole numbers such that P multiply Q is equal to 13. So any whole numbers making a product of 13. So here the question is, find the value of P plus Q, explain your answer. By multiplying, the answer is 13. Any whole numbers, any two whole numbers, but when you add these whole numbers, what is the answer? We want to know what is the answer when we add two whole numbers, the same two whole numbers. Right, so since 13 already solved, since 13 is prime number, so 1 and 13 are only its two factors. So it is divisible by 13 itself. So 1 and 13 are the factors. So it does not matter whether P or Q, 1 or 13, as we only want to find the value of P plus Q. So we will add the number as so here P multiply Q means 13 multiply 1 is equal to 13. These are the two numbers. So same numbers we will add, like P plus Q, 1 plus 13 is equal to 14, right? So by adding the same numbers which are multiplying with each other and giving product 13. So same numbers will be added and it gives an answer, different answer, that is 14. So by adding same whole numbers, it gives different answer. Then here is a little fun for you. Last 37 and 73 are prime numbers with reverse digits. Name another pair of prime numbers with reverse, like 37, and if you reverse it, it makes 73. So these are two prime numbers. So I have found two, 19 and 91, 17 and 71, right? So you can find some other if you know. So practice test number 2. So if P and Q are whole numbers such that P multiply Q is equal to 31, right? So find the value of P plus Q. So as we did in the example number 2, 13 multiply 1 is equal to 13. Here 31 is also prime number. So 31 multiply 1 is equal to 31, and 1 plus 31 is equal to 32 will be the answer. So here these are the two factors of 31, and when you add these factors, answer is even number. Then number two is if n is a whole number such that n into n plus 28 is prime number, right? The any two whole numbers you take as n, so when you multiply or add with 28, it gives answer prime number. We have to find out whether it is true or false. So we have to find the prime number, which is the prime number. So whole numbers, as you know, students, that zero, it starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can check this putting the value of any whole number. Suppose if you put 0 here, 0 multiply 0 plus 28, 28 plus 0, 28, and multiply with 0, it becomes 0. So 0 is not a prime number. So if you multiply with 1, 1 multiply 1 plus 28, right, 28 plus 1, 29, and 29, and then here, so when you multiply 29 with 29, so it gives 29. So it is a prime number, right? 29 is prime number. So by multiplying with 1, right? 2 with, when you multiply with 2, 28 plus 2, 30, right? 30 multiplied to 60, it is even number. So similarly, you can check with different numbers, right? So now we move to next page. So this is about index notation. We have learnt in primary schools that possible units for area and volume are centimeter square and centimeter cube. So for example, area of the square, 5 centimeter is 5 centimeter, multiply 5 centimeter, 25 centimeter square. So you can write it like this, volume, similarly with the volume, that was area, and now this is volume of the cube with edges 5 centimeter. 3 times you multiply it gives 125 centimeter square. So here 125 you can write 3 times 5 raised to power 3, and 5 centimeter, 25 centimeter, you can write 5 raised to power 2, right? So 5 raised to power 2 centimeter square, 5 raised to power 3 centimeter square, cube, sorry. So similarly with when 1, 2, 3, 4, 5s are there, when you multiply them, it gives different number, but when you write its index notation, so it gives 5 raised to power 4. That is called index notation. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 times 3 are given, and index notation is 3 raised to power 8. You can write it like this. So then we see that this is a concept given, that when you have the same number written 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, so you count the numbers and add their powers. So here 5 multiply 5 multiply 5. So similarly, when you write 5 one time and add their powers, so it comes 5 raised to power 3. Like this. Similarly here 3 multiply 3 8 times, 3, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So you can write it like this, 3 raised to power 8. Okay, then prime factorization is given. Consider a composite number 18. We can express 18 as product of prime numbers. So 18 ke, factors hum lete hain. So the factors of 18 you can find with the help of prime factorization method. So it is 2 multiply 3 multiply 3. So 2 multiply 3 raised to power 2. This is index notation mein aap likh lete hain, right? So prime factorization is a process of expressing 18 as a product of its prime factors, is called prime factorization. So you can define it like this. So 18, you can do not confuse the prime factorization with finding factors. So finding factors is a different thing, and finding prime factorization or process of using process of prime factorization is different thing. So finding factor is different thing, process of prime factorization is different thing. So you have to remember this. Okay, now how to find the index notation. Find the prime factorization of 60, leaving your answer in the index notation. Prime factorization method, this is already you have done in the lower classes. 60, 2 30s are 60, 2 15s are 3, 5s are 5, 1s are 5, right? Okay, so these are the prime factors of 60. So this is the way that they have expressed like this, but you have to do it like this. and simply write it here. Write this 62 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 5. So 2 raised to power 2, 3 multiply 5. So you can multiply and get the product that will be equal to 60. So now we move to, before we go to the square root and cube roots, we will solve exercise 1A related to these concepts which we have studied. So this is, we move to page number 13, right? So exercise is 1A, right? So basic level questions are given here. Determine whether each of the following is prime or composite number. These few numbers are given, so we have to see whether these numbers are prime numbers or composite numbers. So I have done this for you. Determine whether the following are prime or composite numbers. So 87 is given. 87 ko we check with the prime factorization method. So 1, 3, 29 are the prime factors of 87, so it is composite number. 67, it doesn't have factors, so it is divisible by itself. So 1 multiply 67 is equal to 67. This is prime number. 73 doesn't have factors. 1 multiply 73 is equal to 73, so it is divisible by itself, so it is also prime. 91 is also prime number, right? So then we see here question number 2. Find the prime factorization of each of the following numbers, leaving your answer in the index notation. ठीक है, so you have to write the answer in the index notation in choosing the powers of the numbers. So let's see, I have done this questions for you. Question number 2, find the prime factorization index notation. So 72 is given. 72 we check the prime factors through prime factorization method. 72, 236 are, 218 are, 29 are, 39 are, 33 are. So these are the prime factors of 72. So we have to write them in index notation. So 2 are written 3 times. So 2 raised to power 3, 3 raised to power 2. This is the index notation. Index notation you can say. Right? So B part 187 is given. So the prime factors are 11 and 17 of 187. So 11 and 17 are 187, right? So there are two numbers that we can write in index notation. So similarly, we'll give the answer as it is. So 36 is given, 336. The prime factors of 336 we have taken. So these are the numbers, prime factors. So 2 raised to power 4. And 3 multiply 7, this is index notation. 630 prime factors are given here, right? So I have done this. So 2 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 5 multiply 7. So 3 square is index notation form of this number. Then question number 3, here find each of the following right prime factorization using prime factorization method. So here square root is given, cube root is also given. So we will find the factors and by using prime factorization method. So here question number 3 is given. So first part is 1764, right? So we'll take simply the factors and we write it under the square root, right? So 2 multiply 2, 3 multiply 3. So we make pairs, right? Then we write it like this in the form of index notation. So we take their index notation, then we remove this square root sign and we write 1 over 2 here, right? You know that 1 over 2 is equal to this sign, right? So then multiplying with the power, so then you get this and the answer is 42. Right, then 576 is given. So simply square root is there, so we take the factors of 576, right? Then you write under the square root sign, then you take the squares in the form of index notation, and 1 over 2 is there, then you multiply with the power, then we cancel this, right? Then the numbers you get and you multiply them and get the product, that is 24 is the answer. Then C part is there, this cube root is given, So this is cube root sine 3 is given outside the cube root, so we call it cube root. So 3375, we take the factors, prime factors, we write under the cube root, right? Then we take their cube root. These are 3 given. We take the power, we write them in the index notation form. Then we write, removing this sign of cube root, and we write 1 over 3, and we cancel this with 1 over 3, and then we get the answer 15. So this is again given in the cube root form. So we take the prime factorization of 1728, right? For the numbers we have under the square root, right, 3 times. So 1, 2, 3, 2 raised to power 3, 1, 2, 3, 2 raised to power 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3 raised to power 3. And then we remove this sign of square root and we put 1 over 3 as a power. So then these numbers are cancelled with the power, and then the rest of the product is 12. So dear students, I just would like to ask you, if you know the method of prime factorization method, you have to learn this. Without solving or calculating these prime factors, you can't solve these questions. So you have to practice this. So question number 4 is given. Given the prime factorization of 9801, or 3 raised to power 4 multiply 11 raised to power 2. So already the prime factors are given in the form of index notation. So we have to solve with the prime factorization method without using calculator, and then we'll see whether these are true or not. So this is the question, right? 9801, we take the prime factors through this process of prime factorization method, right? We write it under the square root, right? 1, 2, 3, these are 211. So 3 raised to power, here multiply 3. So these are 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So we write 3 raised to power 4, right? So 11 raised to power 2, right? So then we remove the sign of square root, we put 1 over 2 here, and then we cancel with the power. So 3 raised to power 2 multiply 11, so this product is 99. Similarly, question number 5 is there. Given that the prime factorization of 21,952 is 2 raised to power 6, 7 raised to power 3, find the cube root. Okay? So without using calculator, same 4 and 5 questions are same. So you have to do this very carefully, right? So this is question. So cube root is given 21,952. Take the prime factors, then put it under the cube root. Then take their cubes, index notation, and then remove sign and put 1 over 3 here. Then you, these base 2 are same, base is same, so I have added these powers. 3 plus 3, 6, and 7 raised to power 3. So we cancel with the power, 1 over 3 ko multiply kar denge, and with dono powers ke saath, then we get 2 raised to power 2 multiply 7. So 2 raised to power 2 means 2 multiply 2, 7, and the product is 28. So that's all for today, question number 5, and rest of the questions we will do in the next video. Thank you very much.